power in me.
He's dangerous. I want you to know this. Many times, we've not understood why we've stayed so long in church. Because of despised God. The Bible says, let me
read.
Amen. Have you seen where long life comes from? It's from obeying your parents. However much your parents mistreated you, before you look at the bad thing she did, remember the days she carried you in the womb. Never look at the mistakes in your parents. Never see their mistakes. Because your existence is because of them. Now if you obey that parent, you are going to see good things. And even you live long. Long life is not only in prayer. The good things are not in prayer. We get the good things by obeying our parents. What will show that God is
yeah,
are the good things that come out of you when you obey your parents, when you obey your pastor, so long as there are people who stand before you and the priest is about God, just respect that your life will be good and long. But if God is not in you, whatever he speaks, you feel disgusted. Over opens the mouth. There is no sense even in what he says. And yet you cannot leave that place. If you go somewhere and you're not comfortable with that person, at least better leave. Now, the pastor and the parents have two issues. There is a curse. They have a blessing. When you handle with care, you get a blessing. When you handle badly, you get a curse. Because your days will be short. Instead of getting the good things you
want.
Now, some people are here. You are not in good terms with your parents. Go back, be like a stupid person. Get something, get a gift. Go and say sorry to your parents. If he's still alive, maybe he was in that
life.
Send some people to bring him over to you that you may get in touch with him. Maybe he's the one binding you, or he's the one who's going to release you. Praise him. He said that is the first command. Whenever you feel like you don't want to err, that means God is within you. If he sits, if he abides in you, you get every good thing without even praying, without even fasting. Now the devil can take away all your knowledge and then get small things and gives them to you, and then he wastes your years. He gives obunyomi. And you feel like, hey, you're so big. And then the devil says, that's enough. That is enough to spoil all your prayers. Because he has known the person he has despised. So I respect all the ministers. Whoever prayer person that comes, whoever intercessor that comes, I want you to know that. Why do I respect you? Because I don't know why God has brought. Maybe you came because you're my friend. Now, if I don't understand that God has brought, then I've not known God. Now when you go to that pastor, when you are driving, when you are looking good, you don't know those ones. Somebody was chased away by the pastor because she was looking
back.
Now the person you think to is the one who will be a blessing. Because you don't know why God has kept him. God has kept him that his name may be glorified. Amen. That is why my prayer is, God, bring the poor and you make them rich. Bring the rich that you may enlarge their territory. Now I don't know which category you fit in, but that is my prayer. Bring the sick and heal them. This place, make it a pool of living water. They will just step here and their life will change. That is my prayer. I pray for you when you're coming. I've prayed already. So you just come in the morning. You just sing in the morning. Amen. There are things that can make you know God. So that's why the Bible says, if you know the truth, then the truth will set you free. Begin to check yourself. Do I have God? Do I have love? Do I have mercy? Do I wish good for others? Whatever that you want God to do, just send it, but do it sample. You don't have even to use millions. God can appreciate even your 100. Because inside your heart you are a giver. Whenever you have a giving spirit, that is a gift of God. And that means God provides, and then you provide to others. When you become a mighty, that means God will not give you. The Bible says a soul that gives. But a miser's fruit will always have nothing. There are things you don't require to pray so hard. It requires just to discover yourself. And when you begin changing your life to be what God wants, when you become what God wants, God will do because you have turned into what you want to do.
to be what God wants. Now when he looks at you, whatever you shall put your hands to receive a blessing. Before you even
pray,
and the heaven will do
what you want.
Before you even
ask,
the heaven has answered. Before you speak, the heaven has already answered. So that time, we are the ones who change ourselves. We despise others. You find a minister and you tell him or her and looks at you. But then he comes and looks after and then prays to God. And God looks at you and says, just look at this one. What are you doing? Because you know how to pray. You shout. If our shouting with Balokoli works a lot, God would have done so long time ago. But God works according to your heart. Endeavor. The way you walk, where you stay, show that God within you, not that God on you. They know you as a prayer warrior, but you have anger. They know you as a prayer warrior, but then you have envy. I had just talked about your department, but they know you as a bad person. Now, if the world knows you as a bad person, what about God? Even as the parents, you the physical parents treat your children well. The child you have, the one who resembles you, the one who has Chabianja like yours, it's not yours. Jalamzuka, that girl who resembles you. She's not yours. Fathers, let us respect our children. I speak about this because I have. I tell them, I say something. They tell me, say something, and then you just look at him. And you believe. And yet, whatever he's saying is not okay. But because I don't want to hurt him, I just take the way it is. And yet, he has spoken nonsense. Because I don't want to hurt him. And said, I told Pastor this and this, but he reacted like this. I'm a physical. I tell these spiritual children, I tell you what. The spiritual one. All of those ones. Now, if you're not so in a spirit, you will break their hearts. You will test them because God has brought them and they are blessed. All of you people here,
I must have the spirit of wisdom to handle you because I need you. Some of you left your churches because the pastors didn't handle you well. They treated you cruelly. They didn't discover you were
blessed.
God will do greater things. Amen. How can you curse somebody? Are you aware that some of us when we come to church we have sickness? Somebody has a sickness called lumamongering. He's a very good minister but he's suffering from a disease. Now that person needs a grip of the word. Every time you give a drip of the word and prayer, because God brought that person as a blessing, but the Roman others are very good ministers, but they are zips. Every man who says something, they'll just go. The person is sick. He needs injections of prayer and the word. He is the one, the man, but every slap. Those, even that one is sick. So that God has brought them all. Every person God brings
here,
not going to be healed from here. But the doctor, just know the patients you have. Because we cannot pastor angels. We are not going to pastor angels. I have seen so many people here with
Kajanja.
Amen. We will not pastor angels. We are going to pastor people like you with flesh and blood. Spirit, flesh that can get weary, can lie. I've been here, they've spoken a lot about me. But even those who speak ill about me are ministers. But then I know that one is sick. Then I treat according to the sickness. But if I rise up against that person, that way she spoke, can even leave the church. Now after leaving, then God demands me that person.
Now,
you lift up your hands to pray to God and he says, you just give that person a blessing to you. Parents, fathers. It's okay.
Yes.
Fathers, you have a child and you mistreat him because the mother left. Now all the anger you put it on that child. I don't know whether we have fathers here. Amen. Just to the council, the child God, you might be the one who will take you to your
destiny.
Now, for us in our area, we have a saying. It says,
"Gabriel
If you have your goats or cows, give them, feed them all. Don't segregate. Because you never know which one you enter in the
night.
You might love this cow the most. Then that one you've loved most dies, and then that one you never loved is
paid.
You might segregate your children. And yet the ones who are the ones who will be a blessing, and the ones who love most are not a blessing. So if you a father, love them equally. Handle them with care. That is a blessing God has given to you. Many do not have them, they die. But God has granted them life. That is a gift to you. But you're now segregating. This one is like a dish. I don't love that one. I love this one. Now you're going to lose a blessing. Because if you segregate this one, even this one here, you have destroyed their future already. God is going to look at the pain you have made this one go through and lift them. After lifting them, maybe you died already. Then these ones will suffer. But the reason for their suffering is you, the Father, you did it for them.